Thank you.
You were talking about February 2nd. Go on.
I just finished the job outside Alamo. Someone called my number just before I went back to the office. She was a woman, a wolf under the property, a mansion a few miles away from Atlanta. She specified that she wanted exclusively my help.
Didn't it seem like an unusual request?
I am the best hunter in the state. Not uncommon to ask for me.
I mean, do you often deal with wolves here in Georgia?
No, not really. Can we go on?
Go on.
After about 2 hours, I was standing in front of the entrance door of the villa. I tried to knock, but without result. I thought about breaking down the door and going inside. Maybe the wolf started lunch without expecting me. Or maybe someone was making fun of my time. In any case, it was no longer necessary.
What do you mean?
I saw the door opening in front of me. Nothing strange, I would think. Of course, except that when I went inside, the hall was deserted. I noticed the phone on a small table near the entrance. That thing didn't stop ringing. That was the first time I heard Emily's voice.
Do you mean Miss Wells?
She thought I was her father. I asked if her parents were home, but she told me that she hadn't seen her father in years and that her mother was dead. No parents, no rewards. I had no reason to stay. I was about to leave when I saw something moving in the dining room.
Are you talking about the wolf?
There was no wolf. I've never seen such a beast. I went to the dining room and took my rifle out of the holster. I shot my whole magazine in the head of that bastard. And you know the funny thing? No scratches. No wounds. Nothing at all. I know what you're thinking, but I've been doing this for 30 years, and I've never missed a shot in my life. I was with my back against the wall. For the first time, I was the prey.
How did you save yourself?
Emily saved me. She was also in the dining room, but on the opposite side of the room. She was there, but as I already told you calling, I couldn't see her. The sound of her bell managed to distract the beast. I used the opportunity to leave the room and close the door behind me. At that point, I tried to leave the villa, but the front door was locked.
So what did you do?
Emily explained to me that I had no choice. If I wanted to leave the house, I had to go to her father's personal laboratory. There, I would have found an emergency exit or something like that. Why was she helping me? She didn't tell me, and I honestly didn't ask. She had did that. The entrance was hidden in the parents' bedroom, but without the father's magnetic card, I couldn't unlock it. We had to find it, and this is where the story gets interesting. I think I need some whiskey.
Mm-hmm.